Rainbow Six Siege Operation Outbreak. Man, oh man, if you guys saw my live streams, I was having so much fun using Capcan and Tachanka. These guys are just like Swiss cheese army right there, because with their freaking sass, I was just like chewing down the zombies pretty easily, just cleaning up the floors. So today, people, I want to review this game mode. I want to tell you guys how fun it is. I want to tell you guys what to expect, because if you guys didn't see my last live stream about this, I actually did pass all three missions that were available in this mode in a single night. It is save Jaeger, save the farm, and save Dr. McIntosh. So I passed all three of them, right? And I can tell you this, there is one game you can compare this mode to, and it is Call of Duty Ghosts Alien Mode. You see, the Alien Mode in Call of Duty Ghosts, pretty much, you know, they drop you down, you have to do some certain missions to proceed in the map, and at the end you get a little cutscene, right? It is similar to that, but I think Rainbow Six Siege does it a little bit better with the realism. I mean, there's recoil on your weapons, the amount of speed that your character has is a little bit slow, and it's a little bit more realistic compared to this arcade game of Call of Duty. So I'll go mostly with Rainbow Six Siege on this. So I did have a lot of fun. You know, first off, let me start with this. I did have a lot of fun playing this mode, and I think I do recommend it. I recommend it to everyone. And if you have Rainbow Six Siege right now, play it. It's fun. It's like to like relieve your stress from playing all the multiplayer ranked and all that stuff, because I know how crazy it gets over there. But let me tell you guys about the negative side about this whole game mode. It is kind of short. It is a little bit of a letdown trying to figure out the story about this. And I wish it would have been a little bit longer too, because to be honest, each and every single story takes you like around 15 minutes to 25 minutes, depending how fast you can go. That's one of the letdowns. It was short, but it's a little bit linear. That's another thing. It's linear. Thought it was gonna be like a little bit of an open world and, you know, break into a house and then just like protect the walls and stuff. And it's not like multiplayer. It's like way different. It brings you that another aspect of like what Rainbow Six Siege could have been in a story mode too. I guess this is just an example of what's going to happen in Rainbow Six Siege 2. Another bad thing about this is that there's not a lot of bosses. I mean, there's three bosses, right? There's like the floating guy that glides around. There's the witch. And also, there is a big-ass dude, which you have to make him crash into a wall. And it's cool and all. I mean, once you start playing too much of this game mode, you'll notice that it's just on repeat. Like, it's just not that much of a difference. And also, I want to say something. Were jeans and white tank tops on sale for the previous week of this, before this zombie apocalypse happened? Because everybody's wearing a goddamn white tank top and jeans. I'm like, change it up, man. Make everybody wear like a freaking, I don't know, a different shirt, maybe. Different color shirt, because everybody's wearing a tank top and jeans. Come on, man. Like, they gotta add a little bit of more differential than that, because it feels like I'm playing the game over and over again, and gets a little bit boring. Also, you can use your gadgets. I mean, it's amazing to use Tachanka and just drop down every single zombie in front of you. It's amazing. Everybody can use their gadgets. The problem is there's not a lot of character selection. I kind of wish we had Castle, Bandit, Frost, Blackbeard is not even in there, but they put freaking Buck in there. Like, why don't they allow Blackbeard in there, man? Allow us to choose different characters all the time, but I guess they didn't do that. They put Glass in there, and I was thinking, like, might as well just put Blitz in there, since Glass requires you to, like, keep your distance for each shot. It's a single shot weapon. So, yeah, I mean, there's a little bit of a letdown on this game mode, but if I want to rate it, you know, from 1 through 10, I'll probably give it a 7 out of 10. There's a lot of room for improvement. It's fun, it's fresh, and I think this is just like the beginning of something bigger. So hopefully they do add more stuff to it, more story into the lore, and maybe a new boss along the way, because I want to see a big ass boss that we all had to fight. That will be amazing, instead of like a guy that glides around and a witch that gets a little bit annoying, and a big dude that's pretty much easily to defeat, because all you have to do is just make him bump into the wall and stab him in the back. So it's a little bit of a letdown there. So that is it, guys. If you guys want to see more Rainbow Six Siege, make sure you subscribe for more. And tell me what's your opinion about this mode. You know, is it bad? Is it good? You know, let me know what's up in the comment section. So that is it. Subscribe for more. You guys want to see more Rainbow Six Siege.